fares, please. Hello, it's raining outside. I'm in Newcastle. I'm literally sat in the driver's seat of a bus. No ordinary bus. I'm on a Yutong E10. It's an electric bus, or as Go North East like to call them, which is whom I'm with today at the Rinvite. Hello, thank you. This is all about the Voltra Zero Emission buses.
Based in Newcastle, Go North East operate over 100 routes using 660 buses, and they've now introduced these Yutong electric buses on their routes 53 and 54. That's a 40-minute circular route where in a day, a bus will cover around 150 miles, perfect for these electric units which have a range of 170. Let's have a look around.
So we're on board. One of the best things, it's incredible, is that they've got wireless charging points behind the seats with little clips, so you can slide your phone in, and providing you've got a compatible phone, your phone just automatically starts charging. Apart from that, regular USB ports, you've got these screens here with up-to-date information. There's like a permanent hand sanitizer point put in there, flip down seats. The seats at the back, you have to go up a couple of steps to get to those. Tap on, tap off, everything's becoming contactless nowadays. And over here, we've got Colin Barnes, who's here to tell us why Go North East are going electric.
As a large operator, you know, we've always wanted to do something for the local environment. We're always looking for alternative fuels and what's next. So it was a natural choice to go electric. We can't fully electrify all of our fleet of 660 vehicles immediately, but there's a plan. There's a plan to slowly move to fully electric. It may take a little while as the manufacturers become more and more better at building the vehicles and giving better range. But this is a first nine. We've just ordered another nine. Once again, there'll be a very exciting new bus, giving a fantastic offering to our customers. They are cleaner, they are quieter, but also for me, on the engineering side, there's much less maintenance, they're more reliable. You know, there's less oils, there's less things to go wrong, so they become a much more reliable vehicle and much better for the environment as well.
And Colin has an app on his phone where he can keep track of where his buses are during the day.
So basically, I've got an app. I watch the vehicles all the time on the night time. I'm monitoring the vehicles and how they're doing. So basically, there's a vehicle there. I'm looking at it now. It's got 86% charge. It's done nearly 43 kilometres today, and it's only using 1.09 kilowatt hours per kilometre, which is very good. I monitor this on the night time, and just to make sure everything's fine. And also I'm making sure the vehicles are charged and just making sure that actually the next day everything's going to be fine for our customers.
The weather has not been kind. Is it me or is there a drop of water on the lens? They won't let me drive a bus, even though I've got the high-vis on, but I'm going to go and chat to a lovely man called James, who is one of the drivers.
So when we took over these, they were absolutely incredible. The build quality, the ride for passengers, the comfort is just amazing. For drivers, it's the most ergonomic cab we've come across. Everything's laid out nicely. We've got lovely new screens, digital displays, new safety devices, speed warnings, collision avoidance, cab heating, full air conditioning, and great lighting. It's just a great experience.
And then, like, do they handle differently? Or is it weird that there's no sort of roar of a diesel engine? You know, how does it feel?
It's different, but a good different. There's no gear changes, it's just a continuous drive all the way up. It's just absolute pleasure.
Colin shows us how you charge up one of the buses.
So basically, on a night time, the vehicle comes round. You can see we've got five chargers. Comes into the lane. And basically, it's very simple. This vehicle's already on charge. You can see the green light. It's already on charge, but basically, that's your charger. Your charging gun, pop it in, and that's it charged. Very simple.
How long do they take to charge?
Well, this charge is 120 kilowatts, so the batteries are 422 kilowatts, but no vehicle comes back empty. So even if you think they come back 20%, you know, 120 kilowatts per hour, 3 hours can be fully charged again. So we don't have really any worries regarding charging time. And these are smart chargers as well. So it'll only give whatever power is needed for the vehicle. It won't just ramp up and ramp down. It'll slowly ramp up the charge, slowly ramp down. Why? To keep the batteries at the best health.
It's a little bit space age, isn't it? It's actually like, it's modern, it's clean. It's like, oh, if you've not been on a new modern bus in a while, yep, you should go on a bus, right?
Yep. Really, we're game changing, and it's really changing how people feel about buses.
Game changing?
Yeah.
Do you love buses, James?
We absolutely love them here.
Why do you love buses?
They're just fun, they're great, and we love to drive them.
Next, Colin takes me for a tour through the main workshop, where all the maintenance is done.
So this is the main thoroughfare of the workshop. Vehicles come in from either side, so you can literally just drive straight through. There's a lot of work goes on in here, but it's now, it's beer time now, so a lot of the guys are on their lunch break, so it'll be a bit more quieter.
And then for more behind the scenes, I took a look at the service control room.
This is the service delivery control office. We're based here at Riverside, and in here we control the whole network, as in support, really, support for the drivers. All of our depots all report through here with any incidents or accidents on the network. A driver might have a problem, they might have an accident, the vehicle might break down, they could have a problem on the vehicle with a certain passenger, verbal abuse, physical abuse, and this is the centre that they would call. And I've got experienced team in here that know the network and all the errors, and they would do their best to support. We also keep records of all incidents out on there. We report through a reporting system and also report any lost mileage or gained mileage through our network. There's quite a few things happening today. We've had traffic lights, for a new phasing of traffic lights being put in an area this morning, and the phasing was incorrect, so it was causing massive delays of up to 20 minutes. So therefore we have to interject and make sure our buses can get around the area rather than getting stuck in the area. And when that happens, we liaise with the local authorities, contractors, etc. to try and correct the issues that are out there as soon as possible so we can all go back to normal running.
Something's occurred to me. Electric bus charging, no internal combustion engine, no diesel, so there's no exhaust pipe, right? Which probably makes you friends to cyclists, because cyclists often get stuck behind buses in traffic, and now they don't have a big plume of up in their face. No exhaust. So Dan is about to do the greatest thing that anyone can do with a bus in a depot. You've got to take it to the washer.
I mean, all buses get washed. This is nothing specific to the Voltras. We just thought it would be a fun thing to do.
I got wet. I was going to call it a car wash. Obviously, it's called a bus wash. The rain has stopped, but I got wet from the bus wash. Now, having dried from that, the lovely Martin Gilbert, who's the managing director of Go North East, has turned up to have a chat with me.
Well, we really, really, really like our new Voltra buses. They've been in service less than 6 months, but already we're getting great feedback from them. We're really, really pleased with the way that they're operating, and we're going to be shortly announcing some more to come to our operation here in Gateshead. It's still evolving technology, so, you know, electric cars, they're far lower mileage, haven't got the sort of arduous duty cycles. We're starting to see huge uptake of electric buses now in London, thanks to the sort of distance and the terrain that they operate on and the funding regimes. But outside of London, buses operate over far greater duty cycles in terms of the terrain that they're operating on, the mileage range, and therefore this is still very much emerging technology, but we're in right at the start of it becoming on the path to mainstream. Also, these vehicles are still twice the cost of a diesel bus, and of course we have, like all bus operators, been heavily investing in the fleet over recent years, so we have quite a lot of very clean diesel buses that have still got a fair few years left in them yet. We're very happy to share our experiences. It's great to be talking to you today, and the team's been very, very proud to take part in this as well. So yeah, we're happy to share our experiences and help deliver more electric buses across the UK.
Okay. Did you choose the name Voltra? Where does the name Voltra come from?
The name Voltra is a sort of collaborative effort between our teams internally and our design agency, Ray Sterling at Best Impression. So yes, we chose that name, a bit of a brand name.
Did Ray do the design?
He helped out, he's part of it. Yeah.
Ray's a legend.
Nice bit of branding, Voltra. I do love the ch-ch-ch, we should make a thing out of that. That's kind of fun. The hot news in, off the press, is that the bus, which has been on standby all day, is being pressed into service. So in the next hour, it needs to go down to Newcastle City Centre and become an active bus in service. So our driver, Dan, say hello to YouTube, Dan. That's Dan, you saw him earlier. He's going to drive it down. But on the way, I want like a hot drink, a tea or coffee.
Yeah.
Can you drive? He's basically said it's okay to drive into Newcastle, but on the way,
stop at Starbucks.
We're going to stop at Starbucks.
Yeah.
So I'm going to get my own personal bus service. Is that all right?
Yeah.
Let's do that. So we're heading out, and the most noticeable thing is that there's no diesel engine. So it's, listen to how much noise there isn't. It's just this quiet bus. There's no of a diesel engine, no fumes, just smooth electricity. It's nice. Okay, so the bus is now coming up to, is it Market Street, Market Square?
Market Street.
Which is on the circular service of the 5354, it's sort of like the termination point where they sort of start, and this bus is going to go into service. Thanks, Dan.
No worries.
How much do you love buses?
Absolutely, lots.
Do you love buses more than James?
Absolutely.
Zero emission power, that is it. Thank you to Go North East. Thanks, guys. Everybody that's hosted me today had a brilliant day in Newcastle. Zero emissions, electric buses, running routes 53 and 54 on the streets of Newcastle. Love it. Thanks for watching.